Hello everyone, it's Commander Evolution. Welcome to Epic Cosmic Journey.
Hey guys, it's Battle Cat, and today we're going to the most furthest planet in our solar system, Neptune.
Oh yes, friends, today we're going to travel such a long distance. The average orbital distance of Neptune from our sun is 4.5 billion kilometers. But because currently Uranus and Neptune located on opposite sides of our star, we're going to travel more than 6 billion kilometers.
Goodbye, Uranus. It was fun being by you. We explored a lot by you. It was fun, but it's time to move on to your brother.
A brother? You funny guy, Battlecat. But yeah, it makes sense. These two planets, very much like brothers. They have a lot in common. And yes, we had so much fun and adventures by Uranus. But it's time to say goodbye. Goodbye, Uranus, and all your beautiful moons. A bit of sadness that we live in this beautiful planet, but much more excitement what is waiting for us in front of us. So far, Neptune is the last of the planets in our solar system. But Caltech researchers have found mathematical evidence suggesting there may be planet 9 deep in the solar system. However, the existence of this distant world is only theoretical at this point, and no direct observation of the object nicknamed planet 9 have been made.
Look guys, we're passing by our sun!
Look at this, friends, we are looking at our sun from the distance of around 4 billion kilometers. It would take approximately 500,000 years to travel this distance on aeroplane. Also, we can observe 6 planets of our solar system: Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn. What a beautiful view!
Our home is so far!
Indeed, Battlecat, but don't worry, remember that our spaceship can travel super fast, and it's nothing for Agamaga to cover this distance. Alright, let's have a look how far we still need to travel to Neptune. Almost there. Just few billions kilometers. By the way, that's me, Commander Evolution, hello! I don't think anyone can truly understand how vast is our solar system. Voyager 2 traveled 12 years at average velocity of 19 kilometers a second to reach Neptune, which is 30 times further from the sun than Earth is. But thankfully we don't need 12 years to get there, because our spaceship can travel much faster. Let's actually have a look how fast we're traveling right now. Look at this, guys, we're about to establish new speed record in Epic Cosmic Journey.
And we just did it!
Battlecat! Yes, we did it! We just traveled 200 times faster than speed of light! Do you guys know how fast is this? This is 60 million kilometers per second, or 216 billion kilometers per hour. Here we go, and we are here. Look at this stunning planet.
Wow, this planet is so blue. From now, Neptune is my favorite planet. After Earth, of course.
Neptune is not visible to the naked eye, and is the only planet in the solar system found by mathematical prediction rather than by empirical observation. Neptune is so far from the sun that high noon on the big blue planet would seem like dim twilight to us. The warm light we see on our home planet is roughly 900 times as bright as sunlight on Neptune. And from this distance, it takes sunlight 4 hours to travel from the sun to Neptune.
Did you know, guys, that Neptune is the most windiest world in our solar system?
Thank you, Battlecat, for your interesting fact. The winds on Neptune travel with supersonic speed. Wind speeds blowing westward on the equator reach up to 2160 kilometers per hour. Most winds travel retrograde to the rotation of the planet. They are 5 times stronger than the strongest winds recorded on Earth, breaking the sound barrier. Neptune has a diameter of 49,244 kilometers, being the 4th largest planet and the smallest gas giant of the solar system. However, it has the greatest density out of all the gas giants. One Neptunian day equals to only 16 Earth hours, but one Neptunian year equals to 165 Earth years. No human has ever witnessed a full orbit of Neptune during their entire life. This planet is very distant, very dark and very cold place, with an average temperature of minus 214 degrees Celsius. Wow, look at this view! That was so cool! We just observed sunrise merging with sunset on Neptune. What an astonishing views! The axial tilt of Neptune is similar to the tilts of Earth and Mars, and as a result Neptune experienced similar seasonal changes to Earth, but due to its long orbital period the seasons last for 40 years each. The atmosphere of Neptune is made up mostly of hydrogen, helium and methane. Very similar to Uranus, its vivid blue color is influenced by the presence of methane, and some unknown factors caused the more intense color. Neptune has 14 known moons, with only one notable large moon, Triton. The rest are more like asteroids. Also, Neptune has at least 5 main rings and 4 peculiar clumps of dust called arcs. Here we go, friends! We explored all 8 planets of our beautiful solar system. But there is still a lot to explore. Our solar system is enormous. There is so many trans-Neptunian objects waiting for us. Many people don't even know about them. I'm sure people heard about Pluto, but who heard about Sedna, about Eris, about Makemake, and many more interesting cosmic bodies that hiding in this vast darkness of our beautiful solar system.
Commander, let's stay here for a while. I really like this planet.
With pleasure, Battlecat. I like this planet too, very much. Thank you guys for watching. See you in the next one. Goodbye.
Thank you guys for watching. Goodbye.